I think that is one of the tips I can give to the fellow aspirants. If it comes for the revision, they think that they have to revise the entire book. But don't do that way. Have a crisp notes, short notes, and it should be written by on your own. You don't copy from others.
चीटिंग कॉलेज में चलती है, यहाँ पर नहीं चलेगी. राइट. हाय गाइस, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल. टुडे आई हैव विद मी श्वेता बोडगला, हु क्लियर्ड सेबी एग्जामिनेशन इन द ईयर 2020. नाउ शी इज एन इंजीनियर, सो दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट आई वांट टू ब्रिंग आउट, कि इंजीनियर्स भी ये एग्जाम क्लियर कर सकते हैं इफ यू गो इन द राइट डायरेक्शन, इफ यू परस्यू दिस एग्जामिनेशन विद द राइट अप्रोच. एंड श्वेता विल बी हेयर विद मी टुडे टू टेल यू कि क्या करना चाहिए, क्या नहीं करना चाहिए, हाउ टू प्रिपेयर, हाउ नॉट टू प्रिपेयर, टू मेक श्योर दैट अ वेरी कॉमर्स इंटेंसिव एग्जामिनेशन लाइक सेबी कैन ऑल्सो बी क्लियर्ड बाई नॉन कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स. सो श्वेता, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंग्रेचुलेशंस ऑन गेटिंग सेलेक्टेड. And I just want to have an idea, how do you feel being on the other side of the table now? You were an aspirant yesterday and a SEBI officer today.
So first of all, thank you so much for having me here. And I'm so happy that I have cleared this reputed exam, SEBI grade A, in my very first attempt. And also I'm an engineer. So initially I felt it will be difficult for engineers to crack this exam, which is more oriented. Finance oriented. But as you said, a right direction is very much essential to clear this exam. And I'm so blessed that I got the right direction at the right time, which helped me to crack this exam. And also I'm thankful to all my friends and my family who supported me in this journey.
Perfect. I think that's the best and the most perfect, answer that we can create or we can get out of any aspirant. Shweta, I want to just recreate the entire story. When you got the result, the day you saw that, okay, I am also one of the SEBI officers now, what was the first experience or the first reaction of the entire family?
Initially, it was unbelievable. I was just checking the merit list. And when I saw my roll number, it took me a moment to realize that, okay, I have cleared this exam. And my family were very happy that I cleared this.
Perfect, perfect. I think the happiness that we see on our parents' faces when we clear such an esteemed examination is priceless, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, you are an engineer. Why and when did you decide to write this examination, thinking well in advance and knowing well in advance that this is going to be a very finance-oriented and a very, commerce-oriented examination?
Sir, initially, I was not ready to apply for this exam. As you said, it is more finance-oriented and I was not aware of any of these subjects like costing, accounts and all. But I had a friend who had an MBA graduate. He's an MBA graduate. So I took the help from him. And slowly, I started learning all the new subjects. So for this, I would like to mention that engineers or any graduates, they should believe in themselves first. They should believe in their capabilities and they should assess their capabilities. So when I did that SWOT analysis, I found that, okay, I'll be able to do this. So that's how that initiation had came. And then I applied for the exam. I didn't wait for the notification actually. So I was consistent in my efforts throughout the journey. This is I think that consistency is the key for success. So before the notification, I started my preparation, like I was preparing for RBI. So my finance and management were already done. So when I saw the notification, I had only 4 subjects left and I have utilized the time properly. So that's it.
Perfect, perfect. You were talking about postponement. So the examination got postponed multiple times because of COVID first wave. How did that affect you psychologically and your preparation as well?
Sir, initially, because of the postponement, I was losing interest. But I used to motivate myself that irrespective of the notification or the postponement, I should be prepared for the exam at any time. So I started my preparation earlier. So I didn't wait for the date. They'll conduct the exam anyway. So I was prepared well in advance. That helped me a lot, sir.
Yeah, I think that's the perfect attitude that we need to have, because exam to hoga hi. We all know that exam is going to be conducted.
Yes.
If not today, then after 6 months. So thinking again and again, well, when the notification come, when will the examination be held? That is basically useless and a wastage of time, right?
Yes, sir, sure.
So let me dive deep into the preparation itself. Now that you decided that you are going to write this examination, what was the first step in your preparation?
So the first step in my preparation is I've gone through the syllabus first. After seeing the syllabus, I have gone through the previous papers. Like, since we have the SEBI grade A exam, which was conducted in 2018. So I had taken the reference from that. I've seen the previous year questions to know the types of questions that are being asked. This is about the syllabus and the previous questions. Later on, I've been searching for courses. Then I thought having multiple sources will be helpful to have an edge over the other competitors. So I have referred multiple sources for this. This is my first step in the preparation.
Okay. Now that we're done with the first step in the preparation, which is identifying the syllabus, identifying the sources or the courses that you decided to take, and identifying and understanding previous year papers, what was your sequence of coverage? Because there is phase one and phase two, and then there is quant reasoning, English, GK in phase one, and then there is a whole lot syllabus in phase two. So what was the sequence that you followed?
Sir, as I said, I was preparing for other competitive exams like RBI and also for UPSC CSAT. I had been preparing for quant reasoning and English simultaneously. So I have only current affairs, that is GA section, which I have to focus for this SEBI exam particularly. So, leaving that quant reasoning English apart, for phase two, for the six subjects, and for the phase one, these six subjects, I started from September. Then for current affairs, it was a everyday preparation. Like, it was simultaneous throughout my preparation for SEBI graduate. So I have referred almost 6 months current affairs for the exam. Since the exam was in January 17th, I started my preparation from September. So I almost had 6 months duration for the entire preparation.
Okay. And what about English? Because that is an area which has very high weightage in phase two.
Sir, as you said, English is equally important when compared to the other paper, other six subjects. Why? Because it is marks fetching and also you can score easily. So for in this section, in this English descriptive, we have three sections like pressy writing, then reading comprehension and essay. And for essays particularly, like I have referred Anujinder sir's course, like you have given few model essays. I have referred them before going for the exam. It was very much useful. It will give you an idea like how to structure an essay, like what should be the introduction and the body and the conclusion. So one should have a proper structure to write an essay that will fetch good marks.
Perfect. You talked about, when we were discussing about your preparation strategy, you talked about note making and how did you use note making for revision. Can you just, you know, tell all the aspirants here, what was your approach towards note making?
So, I don't make notes right after the first reading. So I used to go through the content for 2-3 times at least. After reading it, you'll get a basic idea about the subject, about which area is important, you'll be able to identify. So later on, for the entire subject, I used to have only 4 to 5 sheets of paper, A4 sheets, where I used to make handwritten notes, like the important formulae for, in case of, suppose you take costing, we have various formulas which are very important for the exam. So I made a note of it. It will be hardly 5 to 10 pages, which I'll be able to revise quickly. I think note making is very, very important for revision. So it will help for the help you to revise quickly before the exam.
I think this is very important point that she is bringing out. Ki yaar, agar 100 page ka ek aapne bundle liya hai, to usme agar 10 page mein if you're not making notes, then it is not useful. So your revision notes have to be revision format only. Ki 1/10 to kam se kam karna hai. You have to compress it that much.
Yes.
Perfect. English descriptive mein, you were talking about the sample questions, sample essays that you used. Did you write any essays, and model answers before you went for the examination?
Yes, sir. Actually, I started my English preparation after the phase one exam. So we had almost 40 days. So every day I used to write two essays particularly. And also I wrote nearly 10 model tests, like comprehensive tests, all the three sections. So here, since we don't have much typing practice, I think one should write mock tests using the proper keyboard, which will help you to have that in exam environment, so that you'll learn how to type fastly. So I used to write at least two essays every day and also 10 comprehensive mock tests.
I think that's very important. I see very honestly, mere courses mein students aate hain aur majority students sare test nahi likh paate hain, even if they are given. Because ek laziness hoti hai ki yaar likh lenge, and then they end up not writing it. So if you're getting it, you might as well write the entire thing, right? So the first step is covering the entire syllabus. The second step in your preparation was revision. How did you, you talked about note making and how did you revise using the notes, but what was the strategy you used in order to make sure that you were revising multiple times?
So I used to have a weekly plan. For every week, I used to select one subject. I'll try to read as much as possible. So after finishing a chunk of the syllabus, I'll go for monthly revisions. So after reading the entire syllabus for one time, first time, then second time, I'll try to reduce the duration for 3 days. I'll try to revise the entire costing for 3 days and then entire management for 3 days. Then it came reduced to 2 days and later on 1 day. So the day before the exam, I was able to revise all my subjects within hours. It's all because of the notes that I had written myself. And also it was very crisp and short, which helped me to revise multiple times. And here I would like to mention that we don't have to revise the entire course again and again. There are at times you'll be able to remember few points, which, and there are few points which you are not able to understand or remember easily. So I used to mark it at that point. So when I don't have time, I can refer only the few points which I had marked, so that I'll not miss any of the important points before going to the exam. I think that is one of the tips I can give to the fellow aspirants. If it comes for the revision, they think that they have to revise the entire book. But don't do that way. Have a crisp notes, short notes, and it should be written by on your own. You don't copy from others.
Cheating college mein chalti hai, yahan par nahi chalegi. Right. Okay, now that revision is done, the third step that you talked about, that we discussed, was tests. So how did you go about taking mock tests and how useful were they?
So I say mock tests are very, very beneficial. One should write more, as many mock tests as possible from multiple sources. Like you should, in order to have that comprehensive preparation, one should focus on more number of mock tests from different institutes. Why? Because different institutes will frame the questions differently. They'll have a different source material for and sources. And after writing the mock test, I used to categorize them into different parts, like the questions which I had left unknowingly, and the questions which were left like silly mistakes, and the questions which I am not aware at all. So by categorizing this, one can understand like in which subject they're actually weak. So based on this assessment, they can focus on their preparation, like on their weaknesses. Yes, in this way, mock tests are very, very helpful. Also, it will create that exam environment so that one will not feel nervous when they go to the actual exam.
Right, right. So she's talking about two things here. Ek to analysis bahut important hai. It's very, very important. If you write 10 mocks, it doesn't matter, or they're not going to help you if you don't analyze. And Shweta, I think, is successful just because she did that. She analyzed every question of every mock. I was talking to some other selected candidates, and they also talked about the same thing, importance of analysis. And I think the fact about replicating the actual you know exam environment. That is very, very important. You're bang on that as well. Okay, now let's come to the interview. How was your interview experience? If you can talk about some of the questions that are asked and how did they connect your Biodata form, which was engineering background, to the interview?
In my interview was held in Chennai, sir. I think I was the only female candidate from southern region that time. And so the most initially they asked me a question about my educational qualification. Since I'm an engineering graduate, they asked like, how do you fit in SEBI, which is more finance oriented? And then they asked me about the age gap. Like I have done my graduation in 2017. So I have almost 3 to 4 years gap in between. So they asked me about this question. And also there were a few technical questions and HR questions. Technical questions, like one question was asked from what is marginal costing? And then what is forensic audit? And HR questions like where do you want to see yourself after 10 years? And few questions on family background. And there was a question from finance, like what is financial inclusion and what is the grievance redressal redressal mechanism in SEBI? So these are the few questions that were asked. So I think in interview, they're checking the confidence more than the than the knowledge that we possess. They're assessing you as a person, your personality, than the knowledge that we possess, since the knowledge has been tested already in phase one and phase two.
Right.
So for interview, one should be more confident, have that confidence and smile on your face, and be relaxed in the interview as soon, as far as possible.
Right, right. And I can see that your interview was, you know, almost on obvious expected lines. There were no surprising questions, as I can see, as whatever you've told us. So for engineers, it is not very difficult. You just have to convince them that you are going to be an asset for their organization, right?
Yes.
So one last question is, one advice that you can give to all the engineers who are out there and who shy away from writing such examinations, thinking that they will never get selected.
My first advice to all the engineers out there is like, believe that engineers are capable of doing anything in the world. Yeah, they're into many fields. And second thing, like, in order to crack this exam, particularly SEBI, don't be afraid of the syllabus that you have. Go through the syllabus and choose the proper sources. Have multiple sources from and be prepared. When you are prepared, you'll not be nervous for the exam. And try to do multiple revisions. Multiple revisions are very helpful, and do more mock tests. So one, irrespective of your educational background, be prepared for the exam. That will give you more confidence and which will help you to clear this exam easily. This is my simple advice for fellow aspirants.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. And I can say one thing at last. If I were ever to write an examination like JEE or anything, any technical examination, I can probably never clear it. So this shows that engineers, after all, are capable of writing and clearing commerce-based examinations, but commerce students cannot do the same. So hats off to you and hats off to all the engineers who are clearing such examinations. All the very best, Shweta. Take care. And thanks a lot for coming here.
And thank you so much, sir, for having me here and providing this platform, Anujindal's platform, for sharing my success strategy to the fellow aspirants. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.